Good morning, my dear children. Welcome you all to this session. Today's class, we are going to discuss exercise 7.4 from 6th problem. In the last sessions, we have discussed how to do the simplest forms, how to compare the fractions, everything we have discussed. Now, from 6th problem, we are going to discuss. So, you can take page number 154. Okay? I hope you all have taken page number 154, children. What is the 6th problem? The following fractions represent just 3 different numbers. Okay? Following fractions mean what? From A to L fractions are given. Many fractions are given in the textbook. Everything represents the same numbers. They are actually in common. They are something same. Separate them into 3 groups. We are going to separate them into 3 groups of equivalent fractions by changing each one to its simplest form. How you will group them? If they all have same simplest form, I can group them easily, right? So we have to find their simplest form. Only then we can make them into group. So when I teach you, when we solve this problem, you will understand more clearly. Okay, so what is the simplest form for 2 by 12? What is the simplest form of 2 by 12? It comes in 2 table. 2 ones are 2, 2 six are 12. So 1 by 6. Next, what is the B problem? So everything you should find, children. 3 by 15. 3 by 15, what is the simplest form of 3 by 15? It comes in 3rd table. 3 ones are 3, 3 fives are 15. So 1 by 5 is the simplest form of 3 by 15. Next, see, 8 by 50, okay. 8 by 50, what is the simplest form of 8 by 50? Just we are going to find the simplest form of every number, that's all. Okay, in 2 table, 2 fours are 8. 2 25s are 50. So, what is the simplest form? 4 by 25. Next, D problem. What is the D problem? 16 by 100. Yes, 16 by 100. So, what you will do? 16 by 100. Just solving in 2 table. 8 2s are 16. 52s are 100. Then again in 4 times 25. So what is the answer? 4 by 25. Can we solve these two? No, because both are co-prime numbers, so we have to stop. Do you remember this co-prime concept, right? Yes, both are co-prime, so you have to stop this simplest form till this. Next, E problem. 10 by 60. E is 10 by 60. So 0, 0 cancel. So 1 by 6 is the simplest form of 10 by 60. Then what is the F problem? 15 by 75. Yes, 15 by 75. So I'm going to solve this 15 by 75. Both comes together in 5th table. Yes. 5 threes are 15. 5 ones are 5. 5 15s are 75. Yes, 5 15s are what? 75. So 5 3s are 15. 5 15s are 75. Then again, 3 1s are 3. 3 5s are 15. So 1 by 5 is the simplest form of 15 by 75. I am going to write the G here. 12 by 60. Okay. Next is 12 by 60. So now solve this 12 by 60 in 12th table. 12 ones are 12, 12 fives are 60. Answer is 1 by 5 is the simplest form of 12 by 60. H, 16 by 96. H is 16 by 96. Now comes your second table. 2 eights are 16. 2 fours are 8, 1, 8 twos are 16. Again in second table, 4 times. 24 times. Then 4 ones are 4, 4 6 are 24. Okay, so 1 by 6 is the simplest form. Just what we are going to do is, we are finding the simplest form of every number, that's all. 12 by 75, okay? So 12 by 75, now we'll take third table. 4 threes are 12, 3 twos are 6, remainder 1, 5 threes are 15. So answer is 4 by 25. Next J problem. 12 by 72. So now I'm going to find the simplest form for 12 by 72. 2 6 are 12, 2 3 are 6, 1 6. Okay, 1 6 1 are 6, 6 6 are 36. So answer is 1 by 6. Then K problem 3 by 18. K problem is what? 3 by 18. 3 1s are 3, 6 3s are 18. So answer is 1 by 6. Next is your L 4 by 25. Can we solve this 4 by 25? No. So what is the simplest form of 4 by 25? It's nothing but 4 by 25. So listen, from this you can check. You can find the simplest form 1 by 6, 1 by 5, 1 by 5, 1 by 6. 4 by 5, 4 by 5, 4 by 5, 1 by 6, 1 by 6, 1 by 6, 1 by 5, 4 by 25. See, the overall the simplest form is 1 by 6, 1 by 5, 4 by 25. That's all. So totally you have only 3 groups. Now what you have to do, you have to segregate them using the groups. Okay. So I'm just writing the answer here. So first group number 1. Group number 1, what it should have a simplest form as what number? 1 by 6. It should have a simplest form as 1 by 6. Okay, what all we have 1 by 6? What are the simplest form we have 1 by 6 children? 2 by 12. Then 16 by 96. Then 10 by 60, then 3 by 18, that's all. So what are the numbers we have? 1 by 6 as a fraction, simplest form, 2 by 12, 16 by 96, 10 by 60, 3 by 18. So this is what your group number 1. Next, group number 2. I'm going to take the group number 2 as 1 by 5. Okay, what all we have 1 by 5 as group? Just check it. What all we have? 3 by 15. Then 3 by 15. Then 12 by 60. Yes? Then 15 by 75. 15 by 75. So what is the group number 2, which is having 1 by 5 as the simplest form, which is nothing but 3 by 15, 12 by 60, 15 by 75. Next, group number 3. I'm going to write here, children. Group number 3, which is 4 by 25. I'm going to write the group number 3 here. Okay, 4 by 25. What are the numbers having 4 by 25 here? 8 by 50. Then 12 by 75. Then 16 by 100. Then 4 by 25. So what are the numbers we have? 8 by 50, 12 by 75, 16 by 100, 4 by 25. All this number are belongs to group 3. So 1 by 6 is how much? 4 numbers is there. 1 by 5, this 4 by 25 is this much. Okay, understood? Listen children, see, in the group 1 by 6, I didn't include this one. 12 by 72, I forgot to include. So you can include that also. Okay, so totally 1 by 6 is 2 by 12, 16 by 96, 10 by 60, 3 by 18, 12 by 72. These 5 number belongs to group 1. Then these 3 numbers belong to group 2. And these 4 numbers belong to group 3. So actually, what is the meaning? We should find the simplest form of all the given number. And we have to segregate them in 3 different groups. In which one group should have a simplest form as 1 by 6. Another group should have a simplest form of 1 by 5. And another group should have a simplest form of 4 by 25. So you should correctly, you should segregate it. So I left one number from this. Now I have added. Okay, understood children? Next is your 7th problem. Find answers to the following. We are going to find the answers to the given number. Write and indicate how you solved them. Okay, we have to answer this question and you should explain how you have answered. Okay, that is the question. A, is 5 by 9 equal to 4 by 5? Whether they are asking 5 by 9 is equal to 4 by 5. Okay, whether they both are equal or not. How you will find whether they are equal? You should compare them, right? Only if you compare, you can know whether those fractions are equal or not. For comparing, we need is, it should be a like fractions, which means both the fractions should be have a same denominator. Both fractions should have a same denominator, right? But whether we have a same denominator here? No. So what you will do? You will make it same. How you will make it same? You will make them same by using a LCM, right? So what you will take LCM of 9 comma 5. I'm going to take the LCM for 9 comma 5. 3 3s are 9, 5 as such. Okay, then again in third table, then 5 as such, then comes with the fifth table 1 1. So 3 into 3 into 5. 3 3s are 9, 9 5s are 45. So LCM of 9 comma 5 is 45. So what now our denominator should be? It should be 45. So I have to convert this 5 by 9 as denominator 45. Okay, so 9 5s are 45. So 5 5s are 25. Next, 4 by 5, I'm going to convert it with the denominator 45. 5 9s are 45. So 4 9s are 36. Okay, now I have converted the fraction 5 by 9 as 25 by 45. 4 by 5 as 36 by 45. So shall I shift here? 25 by 45 and 36 by 45. In this, which is greater? Obviously, 36 by 45 is greater. Why? Because we have same denominator. So compare your numerator. So obviously, 5 by 9 is less than 4 by 5. But they are asking whether is 5 by 9 equal to 4 by 5. For what you should write? No. 5 by 9 is not equal to 4 by 5. Likewise, you should write the conclusion. The conclusion is very important. You should not stop till this. You should give the reason. No. 5 by 9 is not equal to 4 by 5. This is very much important. Okay. Next is your B problem. Okay. Is 9 by 16 equal to 5 by 9? Okay. Now the same thing I am going to compare 9 by 16 and 5 by 9. Whether our denominators are same? No. So what you will do? We will make it same. How we will make it same? LCM of 16 comma 9. Okay, LCM of 16 comma 9, I'm going to find it. Okay, now I'll take two table. 2 8s are 16. It does not come, so 9 as such down. Then in two table, 4 2s are 8. Then 9. 2 2s are 4. Then 9. Okay, then 2 1s are 2. Then 9. Because 9 does not come in 2 tables, so I am writing 9 as such. then third table 3 1 as such 3 3s are 9 then 3 1s are 1 as such then 3 1s are 3 okay now I am just going to multiply all the things 2 2s are 4 4 2s are 8 and just writing here children okay How many 2s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 3. 1, 2. 1, 2. Okay. 2 2s are 4. 4, 3, 4 2s are 8. 8 2s are 16. Okay. 3 3s are 9. 16 9s are. I am going to multiply it. 9 6 are 54. 9 1s are 9. 14. Answer is 144. Okay. Now, I am just going to convert this 16 to 144, right? 9 by 16. I want my denominator as 144 because my LCM value is 144. So, I want my denominator as 144. Actually, 16 9s are 144, right? 16 9s are 144. So, instead of the 16 9s are 144. So, into 9 in the numerator. 9 9s are 81. Next, 5 by 9, I want my denominator as 144. So, 9 into 16, which because 9 into 16 is 144. So, for 5 into 16, just multiply it and see 16 into 5. 6 5s are 30, 5 1s are 5, 80. So, answer is 80. Okay. So, now instead of 9 by 16, I am writing 81 by 144. I am going to compare with 5 by 9 is 80 by 144. Now you can compare this which is greater 81 by 144 because you have to compare the numerator. So it is 81 is greater than 80. So 81 by 144 is greater than 80 by 144. So which is greater 9 by 16 is greater than 5 by 9. Okay so what we can say? No, 9 by 16 is not equal to 4 by 5. Understood? Just we are saying conclusion that 9 by 16 is not equal to 4 by 5. Understood? So, first we are as usual comparing. We have done this comparison already, right? Likewise, we are just comparing two fractions by using the LCM, then we can say if it is greater or smaller, we can say that it is not equal to, like that. That conclusion is very much important. Next, what is the next problem? C is 4 by 5 equal to 16 by 20. Okay, they are asking is 4 by 5 is equal to 16 by 20. Okay, now we are going to compare 4 by 5 and 16 by 20, right? Whether our denominators are same? No. What you will do? LCM, right? LCM of 5 comma 20. I am going to take the LCM, okay? So 5 comma 20 means in 5th table, 5 ones are 5, 5 fours are 20. Then in 2 table, 2 twos are 4. Then again in 2 table, 1 as such, 2 1s are 2. Then 5 into 2 into 2. So 5 2s are 10. 10 2s are 20. So what is their LCM value, children? 20. So 4 by 5, I have to convert it with LCM 20. Right? So 5 4s are 20. So 4 4s are 16. Then 16 by 20, I want to convert it to the denominator 20. So 20 1s are 20. So 16 1s are 16. So, instead of 4 by 5, what I am writing? 16 by 20. And instead of 16 by 20, what I am writing? 16 by 20. See here, both are same. So, in 16 by 16, 16 by 20, here also 16 by 20. So, both are equal, right? Therefore, 4 by 5 is equal to 6 by 20. Therefore, we can say 4 by 5 is equal to 16 by 20. Likewise, you can say it directly. Okay, both are equal. So, I am writing it is equal. If it is not equal also, you should write no, it is not equal. Like that you can say. Okay, next is your D problem. is 1 by 15 equal to 4 by 30. 1 by 15 equal to 4 by 30. Okay. Whether they are equal. Now what we have to do? We have to make an LCM. Why? Because our denominators are different. So LCM of 15 comma 30 I have to do, children. Okay. Now comes the fifth table. 5 threes are 15. 5 six are 30. Then third table. 3 ones are 3. 3 twos are 6. In two table. Okay. Now 5 into 3 into 2. See, LCM is a general process where you will use in every steps. 5 threes are 15. 15 twos are 30. So what is your LCM value? 30. 1 by 15, I want to make the denominator as 30, right? So 15 twos are 30, so 1 twos are 2. Then 4 by 30, I want to make it as denominator 30. So 13 ones are 30, 4 ones are 4. So instead of 1 by 15, I am writing 2 by 30. Then instead of 4 by 30, I am writing 4 by 30. So in this, which is greater? 4 by 30 is greater. Therefore, 1 by 15 is less than 4 by 30. So, it is less than. So, it is not equal. No. Therefore, I am writing no. 1 by 15 is not equal to 4 by 30. So, we have proved that this is not, these two are not equal. Okay, understood? Today's class we have discussed 7.4 6th and 7th problem. Okay, just it is very easy. Just we are going to convert the simplest form and making into groups. In 7th problem, we have just asked to compare two fractions. They are asked to compare the two fractions. I hope you all understood, children. Thank you.